We have a lot of hazardous chemicals of concern that are used to make solar panels.
This is Sheila Davis of the Silicon Valley Toxics Coalition. She developed the solar scorecard that ranks manufacturers by their sustainability.
We don't want to solve the climate problem at the expense of other important environmental issues, like hazardous waste issues or resource issues or chemical issues that are in toxic issues. And that's pretty much the problem with solar. So it is green, but it's only green in one phase. We want to make sure it's green throughout its life cycle.
For decades now, people have been mindlessly discarding used non-functional solar panels into the garbage. Very often, people even throw them out while they're still in working condition. And this irresponsible behavior provides ammunition to those who oppose renewable energy. This is done primarily because recycling solar panels is expensive and at present, not all that effective. Very soon, however, things might be about to change. Hello and welcome back to Mayar Media. Today, we're going to talk about solar panel waste, a topic that I touched on in an earlier video as well, where I previously pointed out the environmental problems that solar poses. This time around, I'm going to highlight an extremely interesting development that could solve all of these issues altogether. Before we proceed though, if you haven't already subscribed to our channel, could I please request that you do so? We're a team that's working really hard to bring you these videos, and we need to reach 1,000 subscribers so YouTube will allow us to monetize our channel. Your support means everything to us, even if it's free. Now, without further ado, let's dive in. As an energy-producing source, solar panels are quite incredible. They're affordable and cost-effective, and provide clean energy that doesn't pollute the atmosphere or contribute towards climate change. According to the International Energy Agency, solar power is quickly becoming the lowest cost option for new electricity generation in most of the world, and it is now the cheapest electricity source in history. Where electricity produced from fossil fuels costs between 5 and 17 cents per kilowatt hour, electricity generated from solar averages only between 3 and 6. Storing this energy is of course still challenging, but the costs of batteries for storage are also continuing to decline. Despite all the progress that's been made, however, recycling solar panels up until now has still been challenging. Currently, about 90% of end-of-life or defective solar panels end up in landfills, largely because it costs far less to dump them than to recycle them. According to the National Renewable Energy Laboratory, recycling a solar panel in the US can cost between $1 and $5, while sending it to a landfill costs only $2. But now things are starting to change as recent developments in solar panel recycling have made it more economically viable to recycle them. Recycling generally falls into three main categories, which are reuse, mechanical recycling, and chemical or thermal recycling. Reuse focuses on salvaging intact solar panels or their components so that they can be used again. Panels that are still in working condition can be refurbished and sold as second-hand products, while individual components like frames, junction boxes, and wiring can be extracted and used in the manufacturing of new panels. Mechanical recycling involves disassembling solar panels and processing them to recover valuable materials. The panels are mechanically shredded or crushed to separate different components like glass, metals, and silicon solar cells. These recovered materials can then be utilized in the production of new panels or in other applications. Lastly, chemical or thermal recycling involves the use of chemical processes or high-temperature treatments to break down solar panels and extract valuable materials. Chemical solvents or acids are used to dissolve and separate specific components, while thermal processes like pyrolysis and smelting are used to separate metals and recover silicon. Recently, a new recycling method has also been developed that promises to revolutionize the existing landscape, and that is what I specifically want to discuss in this video. An Australian researcher by the name of Binesh Puthen-Veettil, along with his team from Macquarie University, have discovered a new method to enhance the recyclability of solar panels using microwaves. The team found that being able to selectively heat silicon meant that the plastic coating that protects the silicon plate from moisture and contamination could be softened to the point where it can be peeled off mechanically, while the other components of the solar panel like glass and the aluminium frame can then also be retrieved more easily. This method is less energy intensive than other recycling methods and doesn't require the use of toxic chemicals either, which also makes it more environmentally friendly. Recycling solar panels has traditionally been challenging due to the difficulty of separating valuable materials that can be used in the production of new panels. Solar panels are made up of a variety of materials including glass, plastic, aluminium, silver, and silicon, which are often bonded together in ways that make it difficult to separate them without damaging them. The glass used in solar panels, for instance, is often laminated, which means that it is made up of two or more layers of glass that are bonded together with a polymer, while the silver that is used in solar cells is often bonded to the silicon, making it difficult to recover without damaging the silicon. These hurdles have traditionally led to most panels being discarded rather than recycled. Veettil's team, however, uses an ordinary kitchen microwave with added heat proofing to selectively heat the silicon components while leaving the glass, plastic, and aluminium intact. Almost all components of the panels can now be recycled using this method. This discovery is significant because it can potentially reduce the carbon footprint of solar panel manufacturing and increase the value of recycling them. Solar panels are composed of a lot of useful materials that can be repurposed, but these materials are usually present in small quantities, which has traditionally made them difficult to extract. Developments in solar panel recycling are also significant for another reason.
Solar panels last around 30 years, often even longer, but at some point they reach the end of their life. As of now, the waste heap of discarded panels is still relatively low, about 250,000 metric tons. But by 2050, it's expected to grow up to 78 million metric tons. That would be more than 200 Empire State Buildings of old solar panels.
As of 2021, the area covered by installed solar panels in the US that are due to retire in 2030 was the equivalent of about 3,000 American football fields. Currently, only 10% of solar photovoltaic panels are recycled in the US, while the rest end up in landfills. And as more solar systems reach the end of their life, there will be a huge demand for comprehensive solar panel recycling programs in the decades ahead. Until now, it made economic sense to dispose of solar panels in landfills. In the rare instances when recycling did occur, panels were crushed, heated to extremely high temperatures, and treated with chemicals to remove the plastic in a highly energy-intensive and inefficient process. Fortunately, Veettil's method is both cheaper and more economically viable for large-scale recycling, and marks a significant environmental victory as well, as discarded panels have been leaking harmful chemicals like lead into landfills, which can pollute the surrounding soil. The process developed by Veettil's team is patented and currently awaiting approval, and the team is gearing up for commercial recycling. Others will hopefully take notice, leading to more innovation in the domain of solar panel recycling. Thank you for watching this video all the way to the end. Don't forget to leave your thoughts on the topic in the comments below. I'll see you again in the next one.